I'm going to be talking about AP's trial of the 7th editions, how we can prepare 8 tables. So they made some kind of guidance to prepare 8 tables as well as the figures. That thing I'm going to be talking about you. And parallel, I'm going to do demonstration how we can be make a AP's trial table for your research purpose. So that's also I'm going to be demonstrating. So this is my agenda. So today I'm going to talk about AP's trial. Particularly, I may be focus on the table, how we can construct a table in the AP's trial of 7th editions that I may be talking to now. So this kind of table, we may use it for the research article purpose or a dissertation or a thesis purpose. We can follow this kind of AP format only. Just I'm moving to the first slide. What is by AP? That we already know that that is called American Psychological Association. But the primary purpose of a table or a figure, what is the need in the sense to facilitate the readers to understanding of the work? So basically, if you look onto the chapter 4 of the research, normally a lot of tables may be there. What is the need to be incorporated the tables in the research in the sense, even the layman's also can understand from the table. Suppose if you're writing a 100-page report, only the paragraph for reading and understanding is very difficult from the case of layman's. But if you are converting the 10 pages content in a single page table or a diagram representation, is easy to understand. That is why I am normally may given the assignment as a figure based or a diagram based, because you are converting is a 10 page assignment in a single page. So the single page or single diagram or a single table, it describes the entire 10 pages content. So what is the purpose in the sense, it to be facilitate the leaders to understanding of our work in very easy manner. Particularly even the layman's also, they may understand the content or your work, what we did, that they may be understanding. And the tables, whenever you are making any kind of tables in the chapter 4 or any in the chapter 3 also, so sometimes we may use the chapter 3 also, the tables. The tables consist some of the important things we have to follow. First one, whenever you are adding any tables, the table should have a unique table number. Then it means that the particular table should have the table number. It may be table number 1 or table number 2 or table number 3. Like that, the name numbers should be there. Then each table having the unique caption is nothing but the heading. So each table should have the some headings. That is called unique table captions. The next, the heading may be a bold heading, the bold heading. And now in the AP 7th version is talking about the table may be a bold in down the caption, the table caption should be italic. That kind of thing also we may talk about talking in future. Then the table be consistent in font size and type. For example, in your research report, you may have the 50 pages. Nearly 10 pages having the table. So if the 10 pages having the table, all the table having this should be a uniform font size as well as the uniform type. So the font size as well as the type should be same. Don't be used for the different font size or a different font for the each tables while making. That thing you have to be look on it. Next thing, be consistent in font size and type. This is very much important. This we already talked, you know. Then the next one, keep it simple. So don't elaborate, don't be generalized, don't be make it a very big headings and all. So it will be specific, that heading. From the heading, it should be very small, but it will be excellent one. When the people are reading from the headings of the table itself, they can understand what the table is describing. So that kind of table heading should be, we have to use it. That's why I'm using the term, keep it simple. And these are the things we have to follow while you're using a tables, figures, or a graphs. So these are the things. Use tables or figures or graphs only to display main and significant results. So don't be write a wala wala things. So wala the things, you can specify the particular things. You can specify the points. Don't be write, for example, in the case of concept map, now we are making only the specific points. Even come to the case of PowerPoint, we cannot type the PowerPoint as a paragraph. Then it's called as a power paragraph. Here the term is called PowerPoint. So the same manner, whenever you are making as a table or a figure, it should be very specific. Only the significant result only we have to be highlighted. Present information only when it's a value to the reader. So if you are focusing the any value, the value should be readable from the layman's as well as they can easily to understand from the number representation, or you can use some kind of word representation, the word also. But it will be a very user friendly terms we have to use it. From that the people can understand what your intent to convey to them. That they may be understand from your table. Number every table, figure, even the graphs, the sequence which they will be referred to. Then tables should be numbered and captioned above the table. So this also I'm going to tell in which place we can add the table heading and table number, in which format it coming. So which are the font we have to use. That are things I may be discuss in the next slides. Then figure and graph should be labeled below with a number and descriptive titles. So it may be a 6th version, so but in the 7th version some are to be changeable now. That I'm going to talk about the 7th version. This is a thing which comes to the 6th version, so this may be changed now. Now I'm going to talk about the 7th version. I'm going to specify with the AP 7th versions. Then refer to every table and figures and graph included text by using a present tense. So whenever you specify any kind of table captions, we have to use the present tense only, don't use the past tense. Then if it possible, if it's particular table having any reference needed, citation needed, we have to give the cite references if applicable. If we needed, we have to specify the references. That's we have to look on it. Then these are the principles we have to follow while you designing a table. Before going to that, just I'm coming back to the one researcher. So which is our PhD students, one of my PhD students research work. Just I'm going to be show in what manner they did. Okay, so see here I'm opening the one chapter of the PhD. So this is a PhD. I'm specifying the 4th chapter, how she's making a 4th chapter with the different headings and all. Just I'm going to focus that one. Yeah, so it's open. Yes, see here, this 4th chapter is considered 38 page in her case. So each one is to be different and the title, just I'm going to zoom it, then you can easily understand. See here, this is a table, this is a content of the 4th. Then most of the things, if you are doing a quantity analysis, damn sure the 4th chapter consists of a lot of numbers. Now I'm going to focusing on the principles of designing tables. Principles of designing tables. While developing any kind of tables, we have to follow this kind of principles. The first principle is label. What is label? When I showed my the thesis dissertation of one of the research scholars, they're using the labels, like after the table they use some kind of caption, no? That is called label. Even the headings, so each column or each row they put some kind of headings, particularly that is called stud headings, we may use the term, that is called label. So each table consists of this kind of label. Label all columns in a table, place labels next to the elements they are labeling. And that is the first principle we have to look on it. The second one is called design. Whenever you are designing the tables, the design thing we have to look on much. Design the table so as it can be understood on its own. It means that the picture itself or the table itself, we can easily to realize the things about the description of the table. So it's like a user-friendly table. So it may be described clearly or clearly that table may describe the what you are going to intend to share others, no? That things should be picturically, it may be described properly. Then tables and figures designated and supplemental material should also contain enough information to be understood and the work. So and don't hide the information in the table. So once you make the table, kindly explain properly, kindly describe the table with the numbers or some kind of words also you can use it, but look on the table itself, the layman can easily to understand because it is like a supplement of the entire content. So from the table itself, the people may realize what is the table is talking about, that things they may be understand. The next principle is that avoid decorative and phrases. So don't use much kind of thing, much about making very colorful table, or don't use some flourish language while describing the table and all. Because while using the flourish language also, those who are very good in the language, they may understand, but layman's side, they could not be able to understand very easily the Flemish language. Therefore, the dissertation or a thesis should be a layman. You have to write it in layman language. If you have the good vocabulary skills, don't be imposed your vocabulary skills into the dissertation. If you are incorporating, it won't be reached the society, because whenever you're doing a research work, it may reach the society only. But the society consists of a different group of people. If all the people want to understand the table's description, you can don't use the flourish language or a decorative thing. Avoid decorative flourishes which are distracting, can be interfere with the reader's comprehension. Instead of ensure that every element of support the goal of effective communication. So each table number, each headings of the table, it should be very effective to communicate the content to the layman. That's all the principle we have to follow while designing a table. The next thing, table component. This is very much important. So which are the components we have to look on it while we're making a table? The first one, the table, the first component is called number. The table consists of a number. The number should appear above the table. The table, I hope you understand, the table, the caption, the table as a caption, it may comes or it may be appear above the table only. Then the font size, the font should be a bold font. Don't use italic and all in the case of number. Then this, and therefore they've given some example, I'm giving as an example, table one. This kind of number captions, we have to give table one, table two, table three. In the case of title, after the number, we have to add the title of the table. It may be appear after the two spaces. After the two spaces of the table, we have to type the title. That's why one double space line below the table number, we have to type the title. The font style, you can use the any kind of font, particularly the Times New Roman 12, but it should be italic. It may be italic, the font style should be italic. This is second component. This question may come to the NET exam also. How many components it may be comes in the table in the APA format? There's a five component. The first component is talking about the table number. The second component is table title. The third component is called heading. What is heading? So in this case of heading, consists of variety of heading depending on the nature and arrangements of the data. It's like heading, the sense each column and row having some kind of heading is there, no? So based on the depends on the data, depends on the table format, we have to make a heading. Then it includes the column heading as well as the subheading also. So I may tell what which is a part of the table in the next slide. Then it may be appear in the left column, the leftmost column. So it won't be centralized, it won't be the right alignment, maybe left alignment only. So that yes, last time we are discussing about control H, a shortcut for left alignment. The heading always the left alignment. In the case of body, what is the table body? In the sense, the entire body, the entire table is called as a body, a table body. It includes rows and columns, and the cell represent like in the Excel sheet also, there is a C1, B1, B2, B3. No, so it represents the B1 in the sense the B column. So B column in the first row, in the second row, B1 represents. The same kind of cells approach is there for each table having some cells. The cells only we are typing the number, quantity or any kind of wording things and all. Normally when you are making as a table body, we can go with a single space or a double space based on the alignment. You can look on the alignment. Suppose the table consists of more than 10 rows or 10 columns. So based on the customizations, if you want to keep it everything in a single page, you can go with a single space or a double space. This is flexibility. So based on the page setup, you can go for any kind of spaces in the body. Then after the body, we have to add some notes, like a hint we have to add about the table. If you want to give some small descriptions and down the table, we can use the term as a note, that is called notes. Normally in the notes, I mean, the three types are that: general notes, specific notes, and probability notes. Normally it may be appear below the table. The note is a part, it may be appear below the table, but it's not the compulsory to add the note for the all the tables. So if it needed only, we have to be add. So these are the five components is very much need while you are making a table in the chapter 4 or chapter 3. Just I'm going to be give some example how the table. See here, this is an AP table. See, this is called table number. I already mentioned that the table number is a capital letter. Then this is number, no? We cannot be use a Roman letter. This is, we know that this is called Roman letter. Can you know what is the number system we are using? We are using a this kind of number is called Arabic numerals. Arabic numerals 1, 2, 3. So we are adopting in Arabic numerals only. So the table should be capital. The number is to be a bold. Both is bold, but the number should be a Arabic numerals. This is the first component of the table. The second component is called table title. So what is the table title? In the sense, after the table number, we have to go with one spaces. We have to go with two spaces. See here, this is a number of children with and without proof of the parental citizenship. So there is a heading, but this heading, look on this, it is a italic. So I hope you understand the APA format now. That table title should be below the table number, but it should be italic. We can go with, so last time also we are discussing the font things. We have to use the same font for the all the tables, which are using some kind of Times New Roman. You always use this Times New Roman always. So, but it will be italic. So we can use the Times New Roman, but italic font. The size of the font and all, it will be unique. So these two parts we discuss, I hope you understand. The first part, just I'm going back. The first part is number. Second part is title. So these are the two parts. This is table number. This is a table title. What is the third part? So the third part, a third component is called heading. So the heading, the table heading, doesn't each column or the row having some kind of heading. That's only I'm going to talk about now. See here, this is a table. This is a one heading, another heading. Like that, each column and row having heading. Each column and row having heading. So this is called as a stub heading. Normally we use the term stub heading. Even this question may comes in it. What is the stub heading represent? Heading that describe the leftmost column. Normally the leftmost column, this is leftmost, this is a leftmost, this is a leftmost. So which are the things it may describe the leftmost column? That is called stub heading. Normally the stub heading consists of the variable, predictive variable or independent variable only. That only we will focus it. Then the next thing, decked heads. So this is called decked heads, which is called decked heads in the sense heading that are stacked often to avoid repetition in the column heads. So see here. So actually even with, without, for the girls, boys also with and without. So for them, they're using this kind of decked heads, but we may use the term as a column heading also, because I hope you understand what is a column. Column is a vertical base. Row is a horizontal base. This is called row. So just I'm drawing. So vertical one is called as a column. So like that, lot of headings we have to follow while we are making a table. So the third component we discussed. The fourth component is called body. What is the body? So represent the sense, the entire numbers. See here, the each cells. So this is a body. This is also a body. So this is also a body of the cells. So here the 280A, it is a one cell. 297 is a number represent one cell. So like that, each cell is having some kind of number representation or value representation. So that is called body. The body represents the cells. So cells, the collection of cells is called as a body also, which may tell this term. That's why they given the title cell as a point of intersection between the rows and columns. So the point of intersection between rows and columns is called as a cell. The table body, those rows and columns of the cells containing the primary data of the table. So the data where it's available, that part. So where the primary data is there, that part we may use the term as a table body. So I hope you understand the four components. The fifth component is called notes. The first component, number, title, heading and body. The fifth component is called notes. Normally the notes may come, this is called notes area. See here. So the notes may come below the table, below the body of the table, but the note, see the word note, italic font without bold, then we can give some kind of description about this table. About this table, we have to give some descriptions if it needed. So it's not to be compulsory, we can add this kind of description to all the tables. if it needed, if it's applicable, we can use it. So this an APE 7th version is talking about. I hope you understand the components. This is the main thing. So because if you understand the 5 components only, we can develop any kind of table. Otherwise, you could not be understand still what we discussed. So once again, I'm going to tell what are the things is needed. Remove this one. So yes, then you may understand. The first one is called, the first component is called number. The number may comes the above the I'm removing this also, this caption also. I'm removing this caption. Yes. So the first component is called table number. The second component is table title. The third component is called headings. This is a heading. Third components. The fourth component is called body, the primary body. This kind of primary data where it's available is called the fourth. There is a body. The fifth component is called as a note. So normally the note having the 3 types are there. That also we may discuss one by one. Just I'm going back to the each component. I may tell, I may highlight which are the things we have to follow for each component wise. So first I may talk about the table number. So the table number is talking about the some of the important things. Particularly, if you look on to the table number, there is a 4 important thing we have to look on it. One is called numerous, which numerous we have to use it. Other one is called which, in what manner the data may be appear. The next thing, the position. So where we can add the number. Then the last one is called font, which font we have to adopt it. Just see here, the numerous, so if you want to use the numerous in the table number, compulsory we have to use the numerous, but the numerous should be in Arabic. So that's why we are telling the which number system we are using, this is Indo-Arabic numerous. I hope you understand the Indo-Arabic numerous. Why it's called Indo-Arabic numerous, in the sense the number 0 found by the Indian. The number 1 to 9 is found by the Arabic people. That's why we are adopting the Indian system, we are adopting a Indo-Arabic numerous. But in the case of the table, we could not be start with the number 0. That is why they use the term, the numerous should be Arabic. Arabic in the sense, the number 1, 2, 3, 4. That kind of number only we can use it. We don't use this kind of Roman letters. This is called Roman letter 1. This is Roman letter 2. This kind of Roman letters we won't use while writing a table number. So it should be wrong. We have to use this kind of things only. Table 1, table 2, table 3, this kind of Arabic numerals. And the table numbers, where it will be appear in the sense, is above the table. The table number should be appear in the above the table. The position of the table number, it should be a left alignment. It should be left alignment. So don't go with 5-point spaces or a centralized alignment and all. It should be left. It should be left. Then bold. So what is a bold? So the font should be a bold. The font should be a bold. This is a table number. While you're making a table number, we have to look on this 4 important things. One is called numerous, should be Arabic. It may be appear in the above the table only. The positions, it may be the left alignment. The font wise, we can use a unique font, but it will be bold. That particularly the table, as well as the numbers, should be bold. This is the first component. The second component is called table title. While making a table title, we have to look on the some of the important things. That's what I am talking here. Every table should have a brief title. So that we know every table having a brief title. Write a table title in italic. This is important. The title should be italic. But it may be below the table number. It may be below the label number, in case below the table number only. But and the double space. So the table number and the title should have the double spaces. Abbreviation may also define in a general note to the table. So if you are adding any kind of abbreviation in the title, we have to be add in the general note. Note we know it's down is the note. There we can give some kind of abbreviation. Don't use specific note to clarify an elements in the title. Suppose if you are using any kind of abbreviation in the title, you can don't use the specific note. We can use the general note only. So when we talk about the note, there I am talking about this one. Normally the effective title should be like this. See here, there is a example they given here. There is the example. One is called, if you are making the title is too general, we may go with the relationship between the college major and performance. It's totally wrong. We don't use this kind of thing. What is your problem? It is unclear what data present in the table. If you are using the table caption like this, because here we are finding the relation between the college majors and performance. We cannot know what kind of data you are delivering, whether it is a mean data or a raw data or a group data. Nothing is to be visible. Only the relationship between only is there. If you go with much detailed, the topic may be mean performance scores of test A, test B, and test C of students with psychology, physics, English, and engineering and majors. See here, this much of very big detailed table is not needed. It may be very concise in the sense it may be short and short. Short and well explanatory title should be there. This also don't be used. So we had to go with this kind of effective title only. So they given some example, the effective title should be mean performance scores of students with the different college majors. So instead of these two way, we have to use this as an effective method. So whenever you are making the title as a heading, we can go with mean performance scores of students with different college majors. So this kind of title is needed while making a table title. Just I'm moving to the table heading. After that, I'm going to do some kind of example also our Word file. The table heading, so still now we are discussing two components. I'm coming with the third component. It's called table heading. I hope you know what is table heading. This is called table heading. And this also a table heading. So here each table having some kind of heading, column heading, design heading and all. Then table heading should be a brief. Don't see here. So here only the grade, girls, boys. So from the term itself we can easily understand. Don't elaborate the headings. So it will be a very small one, but it may be understand with the term itself. Table heading should be very brief. It will be meaningful also. Provide heading for every column in a table. So every column, see here, this is the first column, second column, third column. So every column, they have the heading. So every column having the heading. Then stub headings, heading that describe the leftmost column. This is called as a stub heading. This is called as a stub heading. So the stub heading means this one. The left most column heading is called like a subheading. Then here some other part also the heading, like the column spanner. What is column spanner? This is heading that describes the entries into two or more columns into the table body. So in this case, the column spanner, see here, there's a column spanner. So here the table spanner. Table spanner in the sense it may be divide the table into two table like wave one and wave two. It's a table, it's dividing it two table. But in the case of column spanner, see the top is the column spanner is there. So I'm making sure this is a column spanner. So in this case, the column is dividing to girls and boys. This kind of classification they made with the column heading. This is called a column spanner. But here there's a two table in the same table itself. This the first table is called table spanner. This is table spanner two. So if you are making a column division, it's called as a column spanner. If you are dividing in a table wise, it's called as a table spanner. Even if you are dividing in a row wise, this is called as a row spanner. That also name is there. Next is called stub column. What is stub column? This sends heading left most column of the table usually lists the major independent predictor variable. Normally the left column, see here the left the left column, it may talking about the independent variable and different variable. So here the grade is nothing but third grade, fourth grade and fifth grade. It's like a descriptive, demographic variable or any independent variable or a predictive variable only it may comes here. That is called stub column. Next is the table spanner. We already discussed that if you divide the table into two heading or two way, then we can use the table spanner. This is called table heading. Similarly, there is another component is called as a table body. So what are the bodies we have to look on it while making a table in the sense? These are the body. One is called table body, may be in the form of numerals, numbers or a words. It's not compulsory to be all the table body should be in a numbers only. See, in this case, in this diagram, it's like a correlation table. But the correlation table consists of only the numbers. Sometime in between, there is some kind of word also may become. The body of the table, including table heads, maybe a single space or one and a half space or a double space. Here they're making us a 1.5 space, but based on the spaces or based on the flexibility from the researcher side. So if they want to make it a single table in all the 7, they make it a 2 spaces. If you want to if you want to add some more points also in down, they may go to 1.5 spaces. Based on the investigator need, they may go with 1 space or 2 spaces or double spaces. That is the wishes of the researcher only in the case of align or in the case of space. Then if you have the decimal values, suppose if they have the decimal values, numeral value center. See, in the case here the alignment is a left alignment. The alignment is a left alignment. But in the case of numbers, see here, the case of number is a center alignment. So all the numbers is center alignment. So whenever you're using any kind of number or decimal numbers, we can go with the center alignment. But in the case of word, we can go with the left alignment. This we have to look on it. Then empty cells. Suppose if you found empty cells, kindly leave that empty cells. See here, this is called the empty cells, but they are not making any kind of other symbol like nil and so we can keep it this kind of emptiness. So don't use the other symbols like not applicable, that kind of things don't be use it. Then consciousness, be selective in the percentage. Don't include column of data that can be calculated easily from other columns. For example, the people may write like this, so male 10 people, female 10 people, then total 20. So this is things very easy. So because male if you 10, female is 10, the total is 20 only. So don't be make this kind of very ordinary things. Just default the people's notes. So this kind of table we have to avoid it. We have to avoid this kind of representation. If male and female, damn sure we know what is the total. Therefore, don't be highlight this kind of tables while writing a chapter 4, making a table. That is called consciousness. Now the last component is called table notes. After that I may demonstrate how we can make a table. One is called general notes, other one is called specific notes, then probability notes. There is 3 notes are available. The first note is talking about the general note, but when we can use a general note, in the sense, suppose the title consists of some kind of abbreviations, we can use a general note. See here, the general note qualifies, explains or provides information relating to the table as a whole and explain the specific uses of italics, bold and parenthesis. Suppose if you are highlighting anything in the table or the inside the body with some kind of italic symbol or boldness or some kind of asterisk symbol you are using, for the description you have to add in the note area. So generally the note should be italic. So whenever you are highlighting note, the below the table, you can use the term italics, but it should be below the table only. That it's called general notes. Suppose if you want to go with a specific note, when we can use a specific note, in the sense, specific note refers to the particular column. So suppose in the column having some kind of A, B, C, D. So here I'm showing, suppose, use this one, remove this one, then you can understand. See here, this is called specific. Why they put the A? Because in the table, they highlight the word A, B, this kind of superscript they are using. So if you want to specify the specific points, the specific things, we can go with a specific notes. So we can give this kind of A represent what, B represent what, C represent what, this kind of things we can go, we can give the description in the specific parts. So normally the specific parts, we can use the term lowercase letter, but in a superscript, we have to use it. Then probability note, normally we are using while making this kind of probability value. See this table, this kind of probability value, they may be highlight. See here, that's called the star mark, asterisk symbol. So this is asterisk symbol represent the that is called two-tailed test. So here this is called 0.5 level, this is called the 0.01 level. So if you are using one asterisk, it's called 0.05 level. If you are using two asterisk, called as a 0.10 level. So this kind of thing is called as a probability. So while you're using this probability value only, we can use the probability note. So this also we have to look on it, because in the fourth chapter we are giving some kind of interpretation based on the p-value. The p-value is not the probability value. When you are making this probability value, you have to look on this one. Yes, I hope you are understanding the five components. Just I'm moving to the one more input. So these things you are not, I hope yesterday Joseph may talk to you later to the some kind of t-test and all. At time he may emphasize what is a one-tailed test, two-tailed test. So otherwise I may take a separate class for what is one-tailed test and two-tailed test. But in the case of API, while writing the table, they have to use this kind of separate symbols while you highlight one-tailed test or two-tailed test. This is simple for, asterisk symbol is for the one-tailed test, so two-tailed test. This is called as a dagger symbol. This is called a, like a plus symbol for dagger symbol. It may use for the one-tailed test. So these things we have to look on it. And if you are using only one star asterisk symbol, it's called a 0 point level comparison for two-tailed. If you are using the two star asterisk symbol, if you are comparing with 0.01 level, it's two-tailed only. But that 0.01 level two asterisk, 0.01 level is called one asterisk. The same manner, if you are going to one-tailed test, we can go with this kind of dagger symbol. For 0.0 level, one dagger. For the two, for 0.01 level, we can go with two dagger. So this is a thing. Just I'm going to be highlight the things, how we can develop a effective or table while using a word file. That I'm going to be highlight now. Just I'm going to be, so come back to the, I'm coming back to the word file. See here, this is a demo file I'm using for you to do the demonstration. So I hope you now you are seeing my word file now. See here, this is a table. So just I'm going to highlight the table, how we can be design it, then how we can be customized like a API format. It is like a general table. It's like a general table. See here, this is a table. I hope you understand the table. It should be capital letter. I may given the number table one. Okay, just I'm giving the table one. Is it correct? The sample, sample example of a table. So just I'm giving the table title. So whether it may be bold or italic only, it should be italic, not in a bold. So I'm going with the italic. So these things you have to look on it. This is called table number. This is a table title. The table number is in left alignment, but in a bold. Table title is below the table number, but in a two spaces. It may be table number as well as this one having the two spaces should be there. That space, you know, control two. So this spaces, you know how to make a two space, in the sense we know this shortcut control two. Always right click, you can go with the paragraph. In the paragraph, you can make it as a two space, a double space. So these things you have to look on it. Okay, this is called the first component. The first component is talking about table number. The second component is table title. Now this is a table body. This is called heading. See here, the bold color. No, I'm using bold color as a heading. See the heading. This is called stub heading. I already mentioned the stub heading is a left alignment. Stub heading is a left alignment. Even the group heading also left alignment if it's a word. Suppose if a number in the sense maybe a center, it may be in a center, but in the case I am making some demo table, where the note it comes in the sense it may be a left alignment, NOT. So the note should be like this. It will be a italic. It should be italic. It should be italic. The note should be italic. And I'm giving some kind of number. So API style. Just I'm giving a say one note. API style. Yeah. So this is only the, I'm making it a table number, table title, as well as the note. I make it an API style. Whether the table is in API format, anyone can tell whether the table is API format. It is not API format. So if you look on here, this is API format. See here, this is the API format. This is the API format because only this kind of heading, not having the entire cells having the closed. Okay, so only the above should be a line and down is the line. We have to divide the column headings only. So this is a exact API format. Just I mark it as a green color just for the understanding purpose. This is our API format. So just I'm going to demonstrate how we can make it this kind of API format table. That I'm going to demonstrate. Before that, I'm going to develop this kind of table once again. So what we have to do, kindly see, I'm going to develop the same kind of table. Just I'm coming down. See the table, how many columns are there in this table? 1, 2, 3. there is a three columns. Row, if you look on the row, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I hope you understand, this is column, the column 1, column 2, column 3. Column is represented a vertical, okay? So the three column, if you take the row, first row, second row, third row, fourth row, I am selecting the rows, fifth row, sixth row. There is a six rows are there. Therefore, six rows and three columns. How we can design this kind of table? So if you go with insert for finding the table, we can go with insert. In the insert, if you keep the table, if you click the table, you may get the table. But in the case, we have to go with the three column, six rows. So it means 6 into 3. So just I'm selecting this one. I want to need a six. So I need a six row. Okay. So I need a column. So therefore 3 into 6. 3 into 6 in the case of column and row, it's taking. So column 3, row 6. I am selecting the column 3 and row 6. So the tables may come here. So the tables come here. Here, see here, just I am going with the control 1 for making here. Yeah. So I am making, say, one font. So you know how to change this one. So if you select the table and control 1, it's a shortcut to make this one. Otherwise, I will do the demonstration with for normal way. If you keep it here, you may get the paragraph. Select this one. If you go with the paragraph, in the paragraph, you can find the 1.5 space or 1 spaces. So I'm making it here 1 spaces, 1.5. Suppose I want making the 1.5 space. Once again, I go to table properties. So here, I may go here and go with the paragraph. I'm making it here 1. So based on the font size, you can, based on the space, you can go with the space. I'm going to 1 now. Just I'm going to type the heading. See here, column heading and heading, just I'm copying for the purpose. So here I'm typing the second column only, this heading is there. Group heading, it may be compiled, it may common for these two. So how we can add this group heading in the sense? Just I'm selecting these two column, this particular row in the two column. If you right click it, I may get the options called merge cells. Once you click the merge cells, just I'm copying this group heading and pasting. Otherwise, you can type as it is. Okay, normally the heading should be a center, that main heading. So now see here, the same kind of structures may come in, the same kind of structure. Just for the understanding purpose, here it's called table body. So everything is a table body. I'm pasting here. I'm putting this in everything, it's a table body. So the same table, now I make it here. So normally we can make the table like this, but it's not an AP format. Just I'm making, suppose we want to add the table number as well as the table title. How we can add it? So we can add it directly here. Otherwise, for making very customized way, we can go with one kind of one extra, we can insert one row above this table. Then it's easy to make it this kind of table number and table title. For that, I'm keeping the cursor in the first column or first row. We can keep it and right click. There is an option called insert. I'm going with the insert row above. So if I click insert row above, see here, there is a one more row is generated. There, what I'm going to do, because I want to merge all, because I want to give the table number one and sample example as a table, like a title. So for the purpose, I'm going with the selecting the entire row and going with merge cells. Once you go with merge cells, automatically it may come. But we have to write the table number in the left element only. I am typing as a table 1. Then we have to give the 2 spaces. Then just to give the title. So I am just to give the sample example of the table. So just this is the title I am giving. Sample example of a table. So, but it should not be bold. It should be italic. Just I'm going with italic. Do you know how to make it? Control I is italic. Otherwise, go here and there is options. You may find it from italic. This is the italic option, bold italic. So if you click, italic may come. Now the table number is okay. Then table title is okay. Then table heading is also okay. Body also is okay. Then only the remaining part is called note. The fifth part is called note. How we can make it a compound? The last part, note. For that, I'm adding one more row in down. For the adding one row, we can go with right click and you can go with right click and insert. Otherwise, there is shortcut for generating a next column as a next row. There's a tab. Once you give the tab, automatically you may get the other extra row you may generate it. There I want to make it as a note only. Therefore, I am going to merge this file, merge this area. I'm typing here as a note. So note, I already mentioned the note should be italic. So select the note and I'm making it italic. Yeah. So this is a fifth component. Just I'm giving the API style as here some note. Just I'm giving the API note. Yes. So now I am the five components are coming. What is the first component? Table number, table title, then table heading is a third component. This is a heading. The fourth component is called body. The fifth component is the note. So like that, I'm adding the five components of the table. After this, what I'm going to do, I have to convert the table like this. Then only it's called the API table. Because in this table, look on this table. So the table consists of everywhere the boxes are there. But in the table, API style is not like this. Just I'm deleting this one. I'm going to convert this table in an API format. So just for, yeah. So how we can convert this table to this format, that I'm going to demonstrate now. How we can make it in the sense, now just select this table. Once you select this entire table, so first you can select the entire table. After select this table, see here, there is the options. If you go with home, there is the option you are getting this one. This is called border options. If you click the border options, you may get the no borders. So if you click the no borders, nothing will be there. Nothing will be there. So nothing will be there. So no border. But I need to go this kind of things on. So how we can make it only here as a border? So I want to make a border in the group heading only. I need to make a border in the group heading. Parallelly, I want to make down also one line. So for the purpose, I'm selecting this area, this particular area. Once I'm going to the border, so I want to make it a top border. So click the top border, the top border lines coming. See here, the top border line coming. I want to go with the down border also. Therefore, I'm clicking once again. You can click the down border. So here, bottom border. Now you are getting the only thing. Just I'm going with the small spaces, okay. Then I'm going with the five spaces for easy to understand. I'm going to spaces of the table body control file. For this five phases, now you can easily understand. So now I want to add one more line in down also. So for that, I'm selecting only this last row and go with border and making the bottom border. See here, the same diagram is coming. Only I want to classify this area also. So now I make it the first heading line and last also. Only I have to divide this area. What you have to do? So I'm selecting this part because this part not having the table is needed. Only this area above I need one line. So I'm selecting this particular group one heading and group two heading. I'm going here and I'm making a top border. So now see here the very unique API style tables coming. This is the way we have to develop here the seventh API style table. I hope you understand how I make the table. So kindly look on it. So this is called table number, table title, this is a heading, the third heading, the fourth is a table body, then fifth one is a note. So this is a manner we have to make it a table. This is called APA 7th version, 7th edition. It focusing, it highlighting this manner only we have to frame the or design the table. So do you have any doubts? You can ask the doubt in the chat box if you have any queries. I hope you understand, no? The entire thing, the same table. See here, now the both the tables look like a same. So this is called APA 7th edition table format. Just I'm going to do one example with this. So this is a table, I'm already make it as a APA version, but normally this table may comes like this. Just for example purpose, I'm going with this. So normally the table may get like this only. The table may like this. So normally the percentage, it's not need one second percentage, only the percentage is enough or percent we can highlight. So the table number, I use a table number 2. then analysis of the symbol in terms of gender, then I have to add the note. Note is not compulsory, so suppose I want to add the note, I can add the note also. So just I'm going with the note. So, and if you want, I'm going with the note. So note should be a small letter. It should be italic also, not in bold. Just I'm, yes, so I'm going with the control line. Yes, I'm keeping this table. See here, this is a table. It may come here. Okay. Now, how we can convert this table as the AP format? I already mentioned that stub heading is to be a left element only. If you are having the table body is a number, we can go with the center element. If it is a word, we can go with the left element only. So now I'm going to convert this table. See, in this case, how I'm going to do? First, I'm select this table. Then I'm going to be remove the entire borders. Then I need to add only this lines from this particular row only, top and bottom. Therefore, I'm going to the border, bottom border as well as the top border. So now it's okay. Top border is bottom border is ready. I want to make it a bottom border for this. So here I'm going and make it a bottom border. Yes, now the table is over. So this way we have to make it a APA style table. So I hope it may be useful for you. Just I'm doing one more example of a t-test. Actually, this is totally wrong because we cannot be add any kind of symbols, and just I'm going to be make it as a unique format. So normally we are going with this kind of table only. How we can, I'm removing the type color also. I will tell you how to remove the color. If you go with the table properties, you may get that options. If I go with the table properties, if I go with the border and shading, so this and for identity they made like this. So just I'm removing the table coloring. I'm removing this table color also. So the table color is options available here only. I'm removing the table color. Yes. Now see here, this is a table, the title. So I'm giving the table as a 3. Table as a 3. I'm giving note is not compulsory for all the table, that's why I'm skipping this one. So here I'm going to, how I'm going to make a APA. So if I open here, I may go here, just border, I'm removing the entire border. So after this, I want to make the border only this keys, up and bottom. You can select and go to the border. First you can go with the bottom, then you can go with the top border. So now the first heading caption is ready. Now I want to make down only this down only. First I'm going here and bottom. So now it's okay. So in this manner we can go with, we can create a very unique things, very unique kind of table. So I hope now you are realized how we can make it this kind of tables and all. So lot of things are there. The future class I may discuss with you. Just I'm going back to my PPT. Even if you are having some kind of standard abbreviations, we can use the standard abbreviation as it is. So like universal abbreviations, don't use your own abbreviations because it won't be acceptable. You can use your universal abbreviation only. Suppose you are developing your own tool, that time you can use your as you like the abbreviations. But the abbreviation you have to be highlight properly. You have to be highlight properly. This is the standard abbreviation tables you have to use it. Just you can look on it in the APA book. They're talking about what is ANCOVA, ANOVA, AVE. Even the table, whenever you're using any abbreviation, it should be a standard abbreviation you can use it. So kindly look on it because a lot of abbreviations are available. I already mentioned that this APA 7th edition book is our Bible, particularly the researcher Bible. The APA textbook, even the Bhagavad Gita also, even the Quran, we can compare like this because those who are a researcher, very good researcher, they may be thorough the entire APA reference book, then only a good researcher. That's why I'm comparing with the Quran, I'm comparing with Bhagavad Gita, I'm comparing with the Bible. So that much of importance. Yeah, so this is a thing. Just I'm going to show some of the sample tables. Just I'm showing you some of the sample tables to you. See the sample tables. So these tables we already discussed, basic components of the table we already discussed. Just I'm going with the other table. In this table, see the table, I'm going to talk about one or two tables only. This is a table, it's a demographic characteristics of the table it's describing. See here, Just I'm selecting the color to mark in here. Yes. See here, the, yeah. This is the table number. This is a table title. This is a heading. This is a table body. This is a note. So I hope you understand it. If you are using specific number, we are using some kind of superscript. This is called as a what is that? Specific note that we already discussed. So there is a five bodies of the five component. This is a sample properties of steady variable table. This is a third table. Then fourth table is talking about sample meta and summary table. It's everything is to be in the available in the APA book. Just I'm going to just I'm take a screenshot and show it to you. Whenever you are making a table, kindly look on the APA 7th version book. This is a table format of complex experimental design table. The 7.6 table is describing about the steady measures table. Then 7.7 table is talking about the chi-square table. It's also another statistic measure. The next 7.8 table is talking about the t-test, how we can be develop a t-test table. Then 7.9 table is talking about the post-work. After the ANOVA, we can do some kind of post-work analysis. That time we can use this kind of table. Then 7.10 is describing about the one sample, like a correlation table is describing. Then 7.11, the table is talking about the correlation table of two samples. Then 7.12, the table is a representation of this example of analysis variance, ANOVA table. So the people having the confusion how we can make it ANOVA table, they're given the clear picture about how to make ANOVA table. Then the 7.13 table is talking about analysis variance, that table descriptions. Then 7.14 factor analysis table model they're given. In the 7.15, they're given us here, regression table. This is a regression table. Then 7.16 also the extension of the 7.15 table of sample regression with the confidence interval with brackets that they're given. This is 7.13 sample analysis of variance. So this already we discussed, sorry. The 7.17 is talking about sample regression table with coefficient intervals with separate columns. And 7.18, it's a hierarchy multiple regression. So the last four is talking about the regression table only. Then 7.19 is a sample model comparison table. 7.20 is a multi-level model comparison table. Like the lot of tables they're providing. 7.21 table of the APA book is talking about the confirmative factor analysis. 7.22 table is talking about the sample qualitative table. Then 7.23 sample qualitative table incorporate quantity data. Then 7.24 is the last table in the textbook, sample mixed method table. So they're given the 24 sample table for us to, it may helping us to make our research tables and all. So in this, so I hope you are getting to the exact components of the table and what manner we have to frame a table for the APA format. And particularly I'm focusing on the APA 7th editions based only. So while you are making any kind of table for your research purpose, kindly follow the proper guidelines suggested by the APA. Otherwise your thesis won't be accepted by the examiners. So be cautious whenever you're making any table, kindly prepare the table with the APA format. So that thing you have to look on it. So thank you so much for your patient listening, so the active participations. Thank you, Jay Bharat.